Well, it is victory for students at the Delhi University as the university's VC has backed down after burgeoning pressure. In fact, he has announced that the university would go back to a three-year course. He attempted a face saver, saying that they were working on a compromise formula. This now sets the ball rolling for the university to begin the admission process for thousands of students who were caught in between the UGC and the DU.
This proposal draws on some already existing and approved courses, and it will supplement courses that existed under the older undergraduate courses under the earlier semester system. This may considerably reduce the time required for reviewing and adopting the older undergraduate courses that existed before the introduction of the FYUP. The university is of the opinion that given the situation where admissions are being delayed and time is of the essence, hence this blended proposal submitted by some eminent personalities to the UGC and DU may provide the necessary way forward. This proposal entails admitting all students to a three-year undergraduate course with honors and will therefore also obviate the need to call for fresh registrations.
In fact, even as the DU has done a U-turn, there are protests that have broken out outside the VC's residence in Delhi. Vijay Kau is reporting on this. Yes, Vijay, take us through what's happening. Essentially, also, the VC now needs to explain why he had to put all the students through so much of uncertainty.
That is exactly what the anger is against, and that is what is manifesting itself in these protests that are happening outside the residence of the Delhi University Vice Chancellor Dinesh Singh. You have students of various organizations, SFI, KYS, INSO. These are all various student organizations that have been protesting, and for a year they've been demanding that the FYUP, the four-year undergraduate program, be suspended, and which has not been happening. So today they stand vindicated, and that is why they're protesting. But now they're demanding the resignation of the Vice Chancellor. As you can see, some supporters and members of the INSO, which is the student group of the political party INLD, are sitting on the road outside the VC residence. You have Delhi police personnel urging them to move on the site. However, they are refusing to move from this particular area. You have more students belonging to other outfits who also planted themselves right here outside on the street outside the residence of the Delhi University Vice Chancellor Dinesh Singh. As you can see, they are demanding immediately start the new admission under the three-year program. So clearly, students are not just happy about the fact that the four-year program has been dumped. They also want that the three-year program be immediately implemented, the admission process to start soon, and also more importantly, they want Dinesh Singh, the Vice Chancellor, to resign, because they claim that the Vice Chancellor's decision to implement the FYUP and the confusion that has been caused after that for this entire academic session has caused a lot of harassment to the students, because of which he should take moral responsibility and resign.
Now, even as obviously calls for his resignation are growing at this point in time, any word from the man who's caused this mess up really as far as DU is concerned?
Well, there's no information, no message, no letter, nothing, no note from the Delhi University Vice Chancellor. We've been here for more than 3 days now, and we've been tracking development at the residence. As you can see, there is heavy police deployment outside his residence. This on your screens is the residence of the Delhi University Vice Chancellor Dinesh Singh. He has been inside. He's not come out for the last 3 days. You've had officials of Delhi University who have been coming at regular intervals and meeting him. You had the registrar, you have the pro VC, and all other senior officials of DU who've been calling on the Vice Chancellor regularly for the last 3 days. They've been hectic parleys, hectic consultations that have been happening. Also, close aides and friends of the Vice Chancellor have also been coming regularly and speaking to him. They've all been asking him not to resign. However, on the other hand, and in contrast, you have these students right here outside his residence demanding his resignation and holding him accountable for all the harassment that has been caused to the students.
Right now, Vijay, as we've been talking about this, the essential part of this is that why has the VC taken this decision now? Why could he not have done it 3 days ago when this mess actually began? Because students, of course, still do not know when the admission process will now begin.
That is the biggest question which everybody is asking, that if eventually the Vice Chancellor had to come to a compromise formula, then why did he take so long? Why, in fact, did he take an entire 1 year? Why did he let the protest fester for this entire 1 year? And why did he let the anger of students translate onto the street? Why did he allow this entire program or this new proposal to be floated at the last minute when students have been left waiting for an admission process? So clearly, the VC has a lot to answer. We do know that an effort is being made to show him in better light by trying to project the fact that there's a third party or a group of academics who approached Delhi University and who provided this middle path or a compromise formula of sorts that was floated yesterday by a group of people. That same proposal was sent to the Delhi University Vice Chancellor yesterday. He had said that he will consider that proposal. Today we know that a press conference took place where the spokesperson indeed said that they are okay with this new proposal that has been floated by the third party, and this very proposal has now been sent to the UGC for its approval. And only if the UGC approves this proposal that has been sent by the Delhi University will the process of implementation of this new proposal, which is in a way dumping of FIUP and going back to the 3-year format to a large extent, is going to be.
Right, Vijay.